Another 4 weeks passed by. Time for the next P2P update and exchange in our community. How was my experience on the performance and earnings of each platform in the last 4 weeks? Which platform did I reduce? Where did I increase? And which platform did I leave? More about this in the following video. And so, hello and welcome. Thanks for watching One More Dime. I really appreciate it, as well as the exchange. As you might have already recognized, I'm currently on Cyprus visiting Alex, a good friend of mine. We already made a video on this channel a few days ago, where we recapped a bit about our personal experience on the market crash last March and our experience on the Corona crisis so far. As private investors, as well as a business owner and as a person, I think it was a really exciting exchange as it was the first crash we had in our experience as investors. And also looking forward for the exchange about this last topic in the community. So if you did not check out the video, I would really appreciate if you would watch it and also exchange about your experience in the comments on this market crash and especially on your learnings, because this was also the topic of the video. What have been our learnings as private investors regarding this last crash? But now it should be about P2P and we will focus on that. So what was my experience on each platform? As usual, let's start with the few on the platforms that you can just get a picture of that. And then we will proceed to the calculations. How much did I withdraw? How much did I increase on each platform? And also about the income performance and so on and so on. And the ranking. Okay, so let's start as usual with Mintos. Mintos, I increased the account balance a bit. As now you will see in the ranking, it is my number one P2P platform by the account balance. But yeah, more about this, I think it's to talk about in the calculations. So I don't repeat myself too often. Now let's just have a few on each platform. Twino, no changes so far. In Bondora, we have the problem still with the limit. I wanted to increase the Go and Grow account values so far that I will earn this 1 euro every day. As you know, this is one of my goals. But yeah, the limit is the problem. So too many people want to invest on Go and Grow for the moment. It was also interesting to exchange about this with Alex, because for Alex, Pandora is the number one platform by the account balance, which is not for me the goal, because for me the interest return of Go and Grow is simply too low. I expect a return on my capital of, well, we have to compare it on a different assets and they have a different approach. So it still is an interesting asset for me. This is also the reason why I want to have this account value of about 6,000 euro. I think the 1 euro return on Go and Grow is about 5,700 euro. Where you get this 1 euro each day. But anyway, it will not be my number one B2B platform. It's not about trust. You know, I have been at Pandora some years ago, about 3 years ago. I have visited them in the office and had some exchange with the team and so on. Everything good, and they managed already two crises so successfully. So yeah, a lot of trust regarding that for Pandora. No doubt about that. Of course, we don't know what happens in future. But the reason for that is just that for me, the 6.75% interest return per year is not enough. Yeah, because I mean, you cannot expect a year like the last one every year on the stock market, because the last one was just, I'm very grateful for that. Obviously, it was not the worst decision to move massively in the stock market last March. And also the stocks I bought have been not the worst choice. Let me say it like that. I did not know that last March, but it turned out to be one of the best decisions I made. So cannot expect the return I made last year, every year on the stock market. But what I expect on the long term is about 8% return on the stock market per year. Last March I was very lucky because there was this big discount and I even have a dividend return of about 8% on a lot of stocks. But anyway, all in all, with the gains on the stock market as well as the dividend return, I expect on the long term about 8% return per year on the stock market. And so Bondora Go and Grow is below, but for me in general, I expect more because of the risk in P2P. I mean, there are some more advantages in P2P. This is the reason why I still have it in my asset allocation. As you know, in my asset allocation, P2P is about 9% to 10%. But still, there is the risk. You have to keep this in mind. There are advantages like the monthly cash flow, and you can predict the cash flow a lot if everything works. Yeah. So there are a lot of plus, and also the liquidity and so on. But pros and cons. On the other hand, there are some cons maybe with the taxes, for example, in Austria and so on. So there are a lot of issues you have to get in mind. But anyway, most important is your money has to work for you every day. This is the most important thing. The biggest risk is to take no risk, as I always say, because then for sure you lose money and cannot make gains. And first you have to make gains, and then you can focus on things like taxes. But anyway, so let's go to the point. For me, the 6.75% is too low. So this is not, I think this, you know, I never know what I decide in future, but it will not be my number one P2P platform because of these reasons. I have much better return on platforms like Mintos and Bonster, which are marketplaces with a great diversification. We had a lot of exchange about how the platforms did in the Corona crisis in the last video on the Investment Talks channel. So I would also like to connect to this last video. In this video, you see, I did not script it, so sorry if I'm talking too much again, but this is what my kind of videos are like, because I like this spontaneous exchange also with your comments and in the community. And we saw in the last crisis, and also a lot of people of you commented it in the last videos, that the platforms that have in-house the loan originator, so which is their own loan originator, where they can see all everything and have the risk management in their hand, performed better in the last crisis. But as Alex explained correctly in the last exchange, in the last video, they also might have the higher risk, because there is only this one company, and if something goes wrong, it's more binary. Yeah? So you might lose more. Hopefully you don't, but you know, it's a long story. Let's keep it short. But anyway, in the last crisis, my experience just as a private investor was just the honest experience. And this is also something important, I believe, that platforms that have only this one loan originator, as I made the list in the last video, like Swapper and so on, Pandora and so on, maybe made a better job. And there were also a lot of people disappointed by platforms like Mintos and Bonster, but which are the marketplaces where they just had of so many loan originators, some that defaulted, yeah, or have problems in the repayment. But anyway, I think we all had learnings out of that. And when Alex, for example, states that so it is maybe more secure to invest in marketplaces like Bonster and like Mintos, sure, I agree on that. But on the other hand, we have to remind some things like Groupier story, where we saw, okay, there's a marketplace, but still the marketplace has a risk between the loan originator and us investors. For example, this was also a big learning, I believe, for Ibanka, for Alexander Melis, for the CEO, which I really appreciate what he's doing his job. So really a plus, because he also is much more taking care about the marketplace he uses for refinancing, because his company, in my opinion, for sure, has a very, very good reputation on the market. Meanwhile, on the P2P, on the fintech industry, but also as a loan originator for his customers, so for investors and for customers who take the loans, for the borrowers. And so it is also bad for reputation if something like Groupier, even if it is not to blame him, for sure, because it's not his fault, yeah? But it's something he tries to avoid, yeah? And he learned out of that, and he makes, as I understand it, much more research also on the marketplaces he used for refinancing meanwhile. And also, for example, he told me that he would pay back the money. I don't want to talk too much about the group story, but as I understood it, he would pay back everything to the investors as soon as he can really be sure that it arrives at investors, which is for me also a big plus that he takes care about this with his lawyers. But yeah, I don't know too much about this story. I don't want to talk about this in that video, but just wanted to explain some thoughts I have. I think maybe it was too much already. But yeah, I wanted to mention these different risks of marketplaces and platforms that have it in-house. But in general, I think it shows us how important it is to exchange about everything, to have a well-thought asset allocation and diversification. And then on the long term, it's a very attractive asset for me as a private investor, in my opinion as well, in asset allocation with this P2P. Yeah. Anyway, I expect double digit percentage interest return on P2P investments. And so this is the reason why it is good for diversification to have Pandora go and grow, but it will not be my number one. So, okay, now let's quickly continue. Why invest? Yeah, I have to call my tax consultant for this tax residence certificate in the next weeks. And what else? Everything is working properly. No changes to the last time. Same at Swapper. Everything is working properly. And here, for example, this is an example for a really great interest return without any problems so far. That's simply the truth of my experience as a private investor. Sure. Still, we have to do also in our community a continuous research and exchange on our experiences and due diligence and so on, and we never know what happens in the future, but so far, my experience. Asset Guru, as you might see from the account balance, total account value I reduced in the last weeks. The reason is nothing really bad. It's just because I wanted to increase on Mintos. I had this new investment on Yuvo and I still want to increase it. So I made some rebalancing, more about that in the calculations. Also, I did disable the auto-invest because the extended auto-invest is no longer available. And for me, it's important to have double-digit interest return again also on Asset Guru, because P2P is for me, if you compare it to the risk, also maybe Asset Guru has, they have the advantage for sure that they have in the background the pledge on the real estate, which makes it also for the diversification and for the asset allocation very attractive as a different asset and approach. But still, for me, anyway, I don't need to justify myself. Let's make it short. I want a double-digit interest return per year, and so below 10% at the moment. We don't know how the market situation will develop, for example, in future. Maybe I have to change. But for the moment, I don't want to invest below 10% interest return. And you cannot, on the normal auto-invest, you cannot make this as a filter. So I don't want to use it, as well as I don't want to invest €250 in each loan because of diversification. And also, I don't want to invest in this German castle property projects. Simply for me, it's strange. Maybe I did not make enough research. But I don't like them, and so yeah, I just make it manually every morning, check the primary market, also get the email alert if there is a new project and if I like it and if I like the LTV and so on, then I invest my €50 to €100 on this project or on this stage of this project. Yeah, that's it on Asset Guru. Let's continue with PeerBerry. PeerBerry, I think we have had discussion about that already in the last P2P update. I don't want to comment anything more about that. Maybe just let's have a few on the comment Rita wanted to make, because I want to be really fair, because she was upset because her comment was blocked, but it was definitely for sure not blocked from me. I did not block her on YouTube that she cannot comment. And then I decided and also had a good exchange with her. So thank you for that, Rita, and for the good vibes again. After all, really appreciate the efforts, for sure. Yeah, you can read her comment here. So to be fair, I also wanted to put it in the video, and however you think on everything she wrote, we can exchange if you like in the comments. But for me, it was a positive end, because I had the offer to leave the platform and get paid out, and I decided yes to accept this, and so everything worked well. And as you can see in the calculations at the end, I also made profit with the platform. So that's it so far. And I will not make further research on the platform. It's nothing bad. I mean, you know, it's you make decisions and Viventor, I wanted to reduce since a very long time, but not like PeerBerry, where I just can talk to them and they say, okay, no problem, we can pay you out here. Simply waiting for the money to come back and hope the best. We already had a lot of discussions about that as well. So nothing new for this video, for this update. On Bonster, you might see that I reduced a bit in the last weeks. There were plenty of reasons, but really nothing bad. It's pretty the opposite because the return on the last month is, where can I see the return? If you, I think here, yeah. Here you can see the current month, 202 euro received interest on the amount invested is a really good return. So everything good, also super contact with the team, and I planned an interview with the CEO, with the new one, Pavel, in the next days. So really looking forward to that. And will also increase again, of course, depending on my further experience, as always. I also want to visit the office, as you know, but it's not possible at the moment because of the pandemic situation. It's simply in really hard lockdown in Czech Republic at the moment. They are not even allowed to go to the office and so on. So it's a real mess, but nothing to blame again Bonster for that. So I hope that it's improving soon. I will make this interview on Zoom. I don't like Zoom records. I prefer to do it on site just because I can see more. But yeah, at the moment it's not possible. So I hope we can do this soon. Anyway, Zoom meeting is also something I appreciate, and appreciate the efforts of Bonster regarding that to answer my some of them critical questions. So stay tuned for that. The video will be online with the exchange with the CEO in the next weeks. We have to record it in the next days. And yeah, so if you don't want to miss it, I would be thankful if you subscribe on my channel and press the bell so that you get the notification when the next video is online and we can continue our exchange, which I really appreciate. Thank you for that. Also, a reason you will see in general reduced a bit this month on P2P as an asset is that I made a lot of purchases on the stock market in the last weeks, but I will make another video where I show you and exchange with you about all my purchases on the stock market in the last weeks. So anyway, now let's see the calculations. How did each platform perform from the return? I highlighted again for me the platforms as I found very positive. This was once more Bonster, because if you compare it to the invested amount, it's a really good return. Same, I think Mintos did perform very well, and also Swapper once more, very predictable and reliable interest return from the experience on the last months and years, and as well as Asset Guru. But anyway, I don't want to read all the figures for you because you can see what I made. In total, it was 790 euro. So this is my P2P income of the last 4 weeks. We are not talking about the months. This is also a reason why you might see here euro with zero, because the e-banker loans, the clients always, I think that's the common thing on e-banker loans, on my experience, that they pay at the end of the month or the beginning of the month. Let me think like this. And so, because it is the 4 weeks between, I always calculate on the 4 weeks time frame and not on the monthly. So yeah, that's just a habit of mine. Anyway, so they will pay, I think, in the next days, and you will see it in the next update. Yeah, it was a bit less than last month, but also I reduced my amount and made some rebalancing. So I think it's pretty okay with about 800 euro P2P interest income in the last 4 weeks. Yeah, so here you can see each platform, what I withdraw and what I transferred there. I reduced completely. I left obviously PeaBury because first of all, they bought back my loans in any way. I don't know why still, but okay. And then finally we agreed that they pay me out, and yeah, so no more money on PeaBury. I reduced Asset Guru, I reduced Bonster, but both of them, there was no reason like anything negative, pretty the opposite. I'm really happy with both of them. It was just because I made this investment on Yuvo, and I still want to increase Yuvo, and also because of further purchases on the stock market, because for me, the banking sector still is basically since the crisis 2008, 2009, they had their learnings. And now, in my opinion, and I also read an article in the German newspaper Handelsblatt about that some weeks ago when I was on the flight to or from Tenerife, I think from Tenerife to Vienna. Anyway, I decided that for me this is attractive investment because they have a really high dividend return with a healthy payout ratio. So I invested in stocks like Société Générale and BNP Paribas and so on. And before that, I was, for me, still the fintech sector was very attractive, as it was in the last years, because it's a winning system, because when the crash was, they made profit because people sold on the platforms, and then they made profit now because so many people want to buy again. Yeah, so I think fintech is also very attractive as an investor for equity. But anyway, it would be a different topic, and also, as always, everything is no investment recommendation. It's just exchange between a private investor, and everybody is responsible for himself what he's doing. But this was a reason why in the last months I even reduced my total investments in P2P, because I simply increased my equity ratio again. So last but not least, let's have a look on my ranking by total account value this month. As you know, I'm usually speaking German, so also sorry for my English. And I did not translate everything here on the Google Sheets, but I will make short translation on what I wrote here. So number one at the moment is Mintos. Still, I will look closely on all the recovery, which is very important, I think. And also for me, it's important how they will develop Mintos card licenses and also the exchange with the team, the office with Martins. All that will be watched closely by me, and depending on my experience, I will continue with my investments there, but still excited about Mintos. And I think the learnings from the crisis could be a benefit for the investments on this platform, because the loan originators, the marketplace, as well as we investors had our learnings, and we have to look forward. Asset Guru, I think I will even continue reducing, just because I want to increase again on Bonster and Yuvo even more, because I like this investment scenario. Bonster, yeah, the interest return is something that I really like on that. In the next days, I will have this exchange with the new CEO, Pavel. Viventor, yeah, nothing to talk about that. 1 year ago, I stopped out invest, and I want to reduce it, but waiting for the money to come back. Then Bondora, there's still €1,200 in the wallet because of the limit on the transfers to Go and Grow. I really hope that they would lift this limit, but still waiting for that. Swappa, yeah, everything, great experience as a private investor. Then Yuvo, I want to increase it again. Then Twino, yeah, also working properly. Via Invest, same. And yeah. Anyway, now I'm looking forward to exchange in the comments. Thank you so much again for watching, for comments, for exchange. You know, I really appreciate it also in our international community. This is why I force myself to do these videos in English as well all the time. No, it's a real pleasure for me. And I hope I can also improve my English by doing that. And I think it's a learning, and yeah. So everything good, win-win situation, hopefully. If you did not subscribe so far, I would really be grateful if you subscribe my channel and press the bell and put the thumbs up. So thank you also for that. And all the best, keep healthy, and sunny greetings from Cyprus. Bye-bye.